So let's talk about what made you start rapping, man. How long you been rapping? What made you just say, you know what? I'm going to start taking this rap thing serious. What made you say, you know what? I got something on this mic. I'm fucking with this music. Oh, did you always dib and dabble in rap? Or was it a certain thing that hit you to say, okay, I got to go for this now?
Man, it's a cold-blooded story behind it. I don't play it short and sweet. Like, I been knew how to rap. My younger days, I was just a cold-blooded freestyler, you know what I'm saying? But I was just awesome what I did at the trap. Like, just keep it G, I just did my thing. So rap didn't excite me. Like, when dudes like Wack or Wink, I signed a UTP. That hand was extended for me, too, to go around there, you know what I'm saying? But it wasn't my interest. Fuck, I'm doing 9-10 racks a day. I ain't worried about no rap, you know what I'm saying? But I knew how to rap. But as time progresses and go through life, I go to jail, my last charge, convicted felon with a firearm, possession of heroin. So when I go to jail, I'm like, you know, just sitting back thinking, I ain't rushing back to get back, like, be an animal or whatever. So catch the docket. Some dudes on the, you know what I'm saying, charged with me, like gun charges or whatever. They threw their gun and got caught. And it was getting 10 and 15 years, you know what I'm saying? I got caught with my gun on my waist and dope in my pocket. Now, yeah, I had a good lawyer, but I wound up doing 7 months.
Gotcha.
So when I got 2 years and had to do 7 months, I'm like, damn, I'm blessed. I'm put here for something, you know what I'm saying? So it ain't to, don't just run out here and just do the same shit. You got to find out what you here for, your purpose. This your blessing. So I come home and I started rapping. And when I started rapping, it was just like, man, you don't need to touch no trap no more.
Yeah.
You just time to get to it, you know what I'm saying? So 2012, I come home, I just start taking it serious.
Yeah.
Went from there.
Dang, that's crazy, man, because I had another interview where a guy said the same thing. Like, he had beat a charge, and it was like, man, I got to jump in this rap shit now because I'm blessed.
See, you know what the thing is, bro? When you acknowledge your, like, when you acknowledge your blessings, that's going to make you find your purpose. You see what I'm saying? So me, like, saying, by me been through, man, I been probably could have been on rap, you know what I'm saying? But I couldn't handle the gift then. Like, just say if God got a gift for you.
Mm-hmm.
My mind wasn't strong enough to handle the gift then. I'm ignorant, I'm in the streets. It's a curse.
Yeah.
He give me money, fame, none. My mind not able to handle it. It's a curse. So I had to go through what I had to go through to mature, to get where I am now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's why I tell niggas the humblest lion you ever meet, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So coming up, who would you say that you was kind of listening to and making you like, man, I feel this man music. Like, I vibe with him. I rock with it, like, to the point where it's like, this shit is dope. Like, I can see myself doing this, or he make me get in my zone and make me want to go chase that bag.
I ain't gonna lie, I never thought about rapping when I was young. The music I used to listen to. I used to listen to a lot of Cash Money.
Yeah.
8-Ball and MJG was real heavy in New Orleans.
Okay.
Yeah, Memphis was real heavy in New Orleans. And we had Magnolia Slim, you know what I'm saying, Soldier Slim. You know, it wasn't that many, but then, you know, it's what you get introduced to. So then I got introduced to North rappers and all that, but more it was just Southern rappers.
Yeah, I know Soldier Slim had that heavy, super heavy impact in New Orleans. Well, it was like that. Everybody know who Soldier Slim is in New Orleans, to the point, if you was in that era, it was like,
you know who he was.
Yeah, Soldier Slim was
that's
that
how
dude.
It's supposed to go when you live what you rap.
True.
You see what I'm saying? Like, a real nigga get his recognition, man. He put in work in the streets, then let her tell about it.
Yeah.
Hey, you should pay him for his music. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's just, you know what I'm saying? So, in light of him making it, besides where that happened, you know, he getting gunned down, but.
Yeah, rest in peace, Soldier Slim, man.
Rest in peace, Slim. Yeah, he was going to be notorious, man. Yeah. Slim was going to be notorious.
And I noticed, man, New Orleans and Louisiana and whole certain states, y'all have a bigger impact on than other states. You know, Texas being the hub for New Orleans music. Like, we grew up on that shit here. Like,
right. Y'all right there.
We right here. We
just
got,
how we grew up on UGK.
Yeah.
I just ain't get the name more, but I know a few people,
we grew up on that. But it's crazy to me, like, when I see, like, I don't know if you know, Baltimore rock with Louisiana music heavy.
And Atlanta.
Atlanta too.
I went to Baltimore one time, long story short, man.
Yeah.
Called a Louis Charles, nothing for bag smoking over there. I went to jail. Man, they asking me about Birdman, Gucci, and he shocked me because I'm like, we don't know this. I thought y'all was on some rough shit. Y'all, you know, y'all asking me about these dudes. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We don't want to listen to them now.
But they
was on them.
Baltimore, they be shot that whole DMV. They were heavy influenced by Soulja Slim, Boosie, Wayne, the Hot Boys, BG, C Murder. You know what I'm saying? You look at different artists that they be talking about Free C Murder, these niggas be 18 years old. I'm right, like, nigga, how right. the fuck y'all even know about C Murder? Right. Like,
man, compared to the music they make now, it'll make you go back. True. And go back to some real, you know what I'm saying?
That's true. So that's
listen,
true.
You get enough of this, man. You know what I'm saying? You back and listen to whole albums now. You know
what I'm saying? Yeah. So when you first started rapping, man, was it a process of like, cause I've been in the studio before and I've freestyle, made songs just on some fly shit or whatever. Did you have to get used to being in there and learning your voice and teaching yourself to flow better with the beats? Or was you just a natural? Or you had that confidence that first time you went in there? Or was it just like, hey, nah, man, damn, this shit a little bit tougher than I thought?
No, well, when I came home, I just happened to be around a seasoned artist, like, you know, Hit 'Em Hard Papa.
Okay.
So Mo Money hooked us up. So I just watched what he do. He was performing, moving around, doing everything. So I just paid attention. When I went in, no, it wasn't peaches and cream. You know what I'm saying? Right. From then to now, just like me taking shape. You know what I'm saying?
Gotcha.
It wasn't nothing easy. You know what I'm saying? It still ain't.
Yeah.
I, you know, that's why I when I'm at home, I'm in the studio every day, eight at night to like 5 a.m, 4 a.m, every day, perfecting my craft. I ain't doing nothing that I have to do for family, nothing like that. I'm in the studio.
That's what's
just
up.
Just trying to get better, you know what I'm saying? So being behind Hit 'Em Hard Papa, just watching him, and me just being a good, I pick up, you know what I'm saying, kind of, you know, helped me along the way. And then I just went from there, just.
That's what's up.
At one time, I ain't used to like to hear myself on the mic.
That's what I was, you know what I'm saying? I
used to hear myself like, nah, I don't like that. But you know what I learned, bro? It's just like, Neil in the Matrix. That's for me, this pertaining to me. You know, no matter how much the Oracle, Morpheus told him he was the one, they've been telling me that. You see what I'm saying? I don't let no fame, I already was famous before I touched rap, so. And I don't let it go to my head, so then it just me forming into the one. Now, see me, I'm starting to see it now. Because from where I was then and now I won't hear myself, now I love myself, you know, on the mic. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like Neil in the Matrix.
Yeah.
Just coming and forming yourself to the one at whatever you do.
And the reason I like to put that process out there for the people that. And some people think, like, even a motherfucker who don't know nothing about rap, or, you know, people who not rap fans or people who listen to music who ain't never tried it, they don't know that that shit is a process, my nigga. You got to go through a whole lot of shit. You got to learn a whole lot of shit. And the first hard part you got to do is being able to put them headphones on and then get used to your voice and feel like your voice is cool.
Mm-hmm.
So I understand that process. That's why I'm patient with rappers, and I respect niggas who is willing to get out there and put their voice on the forefront to be judged, critiqued, mm-hmm. and have opinions thrown at it all day, because nigga, that shit hard to do in itself. That's right. The first battle is finding confidence in yourself.
Right.
So I really salute that. And even with you, man, because you came out and just said it for what it was.
Yeah, like when I first performed, like, OGs who can't stop me, they'll just be like, man, stick to the trap. That's what you're good at. You know what I'm saying? Just everybody, like, I don't let nothing discourage me, because at the end of the day, it just be like, when I say I'm blessed with it, you know, it just be like the way I put it together. But I also have to put in work in myself. To open my gift, you know what I'm saying? It just ain't coming to me like that, so it just was like, I'm here for it, man. Ain't no stopping it, you know what I'm saying?
Got you.